only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was going home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chilling. Click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real.
They say summer is the time to live in Chicago. Well, that's extended into autumn as we are ready to roll under blue skies at Soldier Field. Just a short time ago, this crowd loud enough to shake the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football indeed in Chicago as their guys get set to do battle with the Detroit Lions. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Play fake for Swift. Now Goff sliding out of the pocket. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Swift's got the first down and then some. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
We expected this defense to be tested by this passing game coming into this one. And there's an example on this first possession of the game.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Now it's gone. Looking sideline, incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so he'll just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
Here's second and 10. Goff, a handoff here to Swift. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. The impressive opening drive continues and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Quintez Cephas, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions take it right down and score on the opening drive. And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Now here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now a first down throw, Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Well, we knew that Darnell Mooney could absolutely fly, but he was only taken in the fifth round out of Tulane because of his size. He ended up being one of the better late-round picks in the NFL last year. 61 catches on the season. There's another one there, this time for a first down.
Fields on first down. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And this one is incomplete.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, the so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
The Bears on the move. They've got another first down.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Mike, 53. 53. Mike.
First carry now for David Montgomery. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 16 yards, a little deja vu from the previous play where they got 16. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. On first and 10, here's Fields. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Second and 10. A give. This is Montgomery. And a pretty good run as he'll get this down close to a first at the Lions' 15-yard line. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Here's Fields. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there, they'll go for it on fourth. They snap it to Fields. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Bears tried it on fourth down, unable to convert. And the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
Goff on first down. And his throw is incomplete.
Yeah, good game catch the ball in the backfield a week ago. They're going to try and involve him in that way in this game as well. But you can tell scouting is taking over. They're making it a little bit more difficult.
Yeah, defensively, they told us, hey, we've got to take him out of the passing game, limit it to just short runs, because he can really impact this offense.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. They'll fake the give. Now Goff. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Here's a handoff to Swift running left. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Here's Goff. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. 21 yards there on third down. On first down, Swift. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. On 2nd and 9, Goff. Going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. The sack by Robert Quinn.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
On 3rd down, here comes Swift. And he'll go down at the 28. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a 4th down now. Seibert able to knock this one through. And the lead moves to 10-0. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
Prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a 4th down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like
nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. Romeo Okwara. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Now this one from about two counties over. After the sack, they come up on a second and very long. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Now it's Fields. That's complete to Mooney. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that might be exactly where they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked off by the linebacker, Raekwon McMillan. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you did.
Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack.
Below Nichols.
He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. A handoff, Swift running to the left. He finds some open field here. He's at the 40, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Detroit.
So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates. They're looking at you. And let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works. But he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
And you'll see, courtesy of the next-gen stats, he traveled better than 80 yards on the ground that time.
Jack Fox to kick off for the Lions.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 40. Fields.
flush to his right. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Second down and 3. Now a give running left with Montgomery.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. A shotgun snap, Fields. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank, and he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. On the handoff, this is Swift. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run? Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a 3rd and 4.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. He's on quite the interception run. He had 2 last week, another one here. Remember, he's not a DB, he's a linebacker.
But how many of those linebackers started as DBs and pumped themselves up into being linebackers? So the ball skills are the same, right? The coverage skills and responsibilities are the same, and he is paying it off in a big, big way.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for 1st and 10. Fields now to throw. And for the 3rd time here this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Dane Cruikshank. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
So that's now three first-half interceptions, and that last one even costlier as it's returned for 6 points. So as a quarterback, how do you regain your focus?
Well, QB 101 says you never show them that you're sweating. Still act like you're the guy, that you've thrown six touchdown passes, not three interceptions. But he's human. He's got to face up to his teammates. He's got to own up to that. See if he can brace up and also not look over his shoulder and see his backup starting to warm up. It's going to be a tough one for him.
Now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Certainly not what they wanted there, so the football by rule comes out to the 40.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it?